Direct mail marketing, is it all it's cracked up to be, or is it a waste of time? Whether you are in the real estate wholesaling business or the land investing wholesale flipping business, direct mail marketing has to be a key part of your lead generation because it works. It's simple, it's old school, it's basic, but it works. Here's where many people get caught up. One is the expense of getting it done and the what ifs it doesn't work. So if you've been following me for any length of time, you know I'm in the land investing business. I typically use offerstoowners.com. I'm not an affiliate in any way, shape, or form, so it's not a promo like that, but I use them for my direct mail offers because they charge me $1 a letter. Everything covered in that. You know, it's the data pulled, offer sent out, good to go. It saves me a ton of time. But recently, with everything going on in the world, my daughter was laid off. So I wanted to teach her a marketing skill. So she stepped up and started pulling the data for me online, doing direct mail offers for me. And it was costing me $1.50 a letter. But I'm teaching my kid a skill. And we were able to split test a handwritten envelope versus something more professional coming to the end consumer to see if they wanted to sell. We wanted to see how these would convert. So she sent out 100 letters for me. Look what came back in my inbox. Now, right off the bat, you might be thinking, holy crap, are those accepted offers? No, bad data. 100 letters out, 20 of them kicked back instantly. So this is where most people freak out. They're like, I got bad data, it just doesn't work, yada, yada, yada. Direct mail doesn't work. It's not what it's all cracked up to be. Wrong. Out of 100 letters that we spent $1.50 per letter, so 150 invested, boom. 3 offers accepted. These are smaller deals, but I'll turn around and seller finance these for 25 down, 25 a month for 48 months. And our offer was extremely low on these. So basically, a collective investment of about $450 to $500 is gonna be $3,700 note for me when it's all said and done. That's a heck of a return and well worth getting involved with. So a couple things to keep in mind with direct mail marketing. Your first mailer, it isn't gonna work. Accept it. Not really. You will get some accepted offers, but many people do a direct mail offer. Something goes wrong. The return address is wrong. You messed up your number, your phone number on it. You didn't double check something. You spend $500 or $1,000. You get crickets. You say, this just doesn't work. And sometimes you just get bad data. I've been doing this for years. We still pull bad data. It happens. So don't get discouraged by that. Just tweak your offer a little bit. Mail it again and see what happens. It's part of the investment. You'll absolutely get the return. Just roll it into it. So if you send out 500 offers at $500 and you get crickets, wait 2 weeks, rebound, send out another 500 and just tweak it slightly. So if you were targeting quarter acre lots, try half acre lots and then adjust your offer price just a little bit. Now, another thing to keep in mind, let's say that first batch of 500 that you sent out, you got nothing accepted from that. Know that the deal's not done. Many people pick up their motivation 2 and 3 months from now because at first they see an insulting offer and they're like, yeah, whatever, dude. And they toss it aside, but they don't necessarily toss it out. 2 to 3 months go by. We have a great, crazy pandemic going on. Someone needs their car repaired. Their kid just got picked up by the law and they're like, hey, I need to free up some cash real quick. Then they hit you up. Hey, I'll absolutely accept your offer. What's the next step? So people do cycle back 2-3 months down the road. So just because you got crickets on the front end doesn't mean it's dead completely. You got to keep the offers consistent. If you're broke, you're struggling to get things going, I have other videos showing exactly how you can pull data online, send offers to the owners. And like I said, that's how we did these. We got some bad data on them. But even with all that bad data we got right there and paying a little more per letter, I still got 3 deals out of it, which will give me a very substantial return on my investment. I'm beyond happy. And that's how you got to look at it. The front end loss really isn't a loss. You are going into a business. Treat it as a business. Don't be scared when you get crickets. Just focus, regroup, and if your money's tight, do a consistent 50 a week, pulling the data online. Do a consistent 25 a week, and then grow on that. As soon as you get a deal, flip it, bring the money back, deploy it again. Go ahead, scrape a little off the top to reward yourself, but keep it moving till you get something massive. Once you get something massive, that's when you can start treating yourself to things. It's not an overnight success, it takes time, but you gotta be committed and make things happen. Your money scenario, situation, whatever you wanna call it, should not be an excuse. Like I said, you could be completely broke and still budget in 25 offer letters a week. And if you do them yourself, you're just paying for the stamp. That's only 50 cents right there. Me, I hired someone out to do it. You pay a little more, or you use something like Offers to Owners or any of these other direct mail companies out there. So just want to give you an overview. Even when you're getting bad data, doing small mailers, whatever the case may be, you could still get deals. You're still profitable. So don't get discouraged by what kicks back. be encouraged by what actually comes in so you can make money and keep your money flipping over and over. Now, if you have any questions about the land investing business, go ahead and comment below or shoot me a text at 440-678-1151. Also, drop by takingactiontoday.com. We got the passive income blueprint over there that anybody can use to go ahead and generate a new passive income stream. Literally, anybody can do these steps. So go ahead and take advantage of it. Thank you so much for tuning into this. I'll see you in the next video.